You in your right mind? You the only righteous people on the face of the earth. Pastors, your leaders refuse to go in this Bible to give you a solution. But right now, today, that time is up. There's no more giving you lies.
You're not African. You're not black. You're not Jamaican. You're not from the 12 tribes of Israel. Yeah.
So we're supposed to give a warning.
We're not judging you, we're warning you.
But have we seen any change?
No!
Have we seen anything that has changed our people? Changed our neighborhood?
It's a doctrine. What is your nationality? What nation of people do you come from?
God's
okay. So according to the Bible, you are God's chosen people.
Right.
According to the Bible, you come from the tribe of Benjamin. From the nation of Israel.
That's right.
That's happening right there. I'm going to prove that to you. Because Jamaican is not in the Bible.
Right.
You know that, right? So you have to find out, what does God call you? The man that conquered you called you Jamaican.
Right.
And now we're proud of that. We Jamaican, they destroyed us. Cool, we Jamaican now. We're gonna rock this flag. That's not what you are. You were conquered, they destroyed your people. And gave you a title. And now we proud.
That's right.
Now, I'm gonna show you who you are according to the Bible. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Bring it up.
Give me Isaiah 1 and 3. Because look, you ask a black man what's your nationality, he'll tell you he's black, Jamaican, Haitian. Some will tell you they don't know. Well, we all went through the same thing.
Right.
Why do we have different answers? Everybody got a different answer for their nationality.
Right.
We're going to show you. Read that.
Bring it up.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3. The ox marked his owner.
The ox is a very dumb animal.
Right.
Hear me? Read.
And the ass, his master's crib.
The ox knows who he belongs to. A dumb animal. An ass is a donkey. Another stupid animal. But he knows his master's crib.
He knows where he belongs.
Right.
What? Read.
But Israel.
But who?
Israel.
The nation of Israel.
Does not know.
They don't know who they are. They don't know where they belong. They don't know their nationality. Read.
My people.
God's people.
Does not consider.
They don't even think that. Wait, I might be God's chosen people.
Right.
I might be the one that's written of in this Bible.
Right.
My history might be in this Bible.
Right.
Your Christian pastor won't tell you that though. But I'm telling you today, God's telling you today, that you are an Israelite from the tribe of Benjamin. I'm going to prove that to you. Give me Deuteronomy 28:15.
Bring it
out.
28:29:1. Because you know who Moses is? Moses was a prophet.
Right.
He delivered the nation of Israel out of captivity, out of bondage, out of slavery. This is what, after he delivered them, after God delivered the nation of Israel, he made a contract with them.
Right.
I did this for you? Cool. There's stipulations for this thing.
Right.
Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 1. These are the words of the covenant.
You know what a covenant is? A covenant is a contract. If I make you sign a contract, you better abide to what you autographed on that contract.
Right.
Read.
These are the words of the covenant which the Lord commanded Moses to make with the children of Israel.
So he spoke to the children of Israel and said, hey, I just delivered y'all. This is my contract. Now better listen to this. Verse 28:15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass.
Now, in the contract, there's a good side. Hey, you do this, cool. You get rewarded. But if you don't, there's penalties. There's a consequence. Life teaches you that generally. read. But it shall come to pass.
But it will come to pass. Moses lived a long time ago. This is future. He's speaking future. Can't no man tell you what's going to happen tomorrow. God can tell you what's going to happen tomorrow.
That's right.
Read what you got.
But it shall come to pass.
This is what's going to happen.
If thou.
If you. What's your name again? Excuse me?
Anthony. If you. Read. If thou.
Anthony.
Will not hearken.
If Anthony does not listen.
Unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Your God.
To observe. To do all his commandments.
All his commandments. In church they tell you, oh, keep ten. You know, don't kill. Don't steal.
Right.
And you could.
You know.
You can lie here and there. You know. You can gossip here and there.
Right.
You can sell drugs to your brothers. But as long as you go to church on Sunday, cool.
Read. To himself to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee,
God commanded you, Anthony,
this day, that all these curses,
if you do not listen, then what?
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Wait. There's a bad side to the contract if you don't listen, Anthony. Give me Daniel 9 and 11. Because the nation of Israel, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans did not observe God's laws.
Right.
Hold that sign up for me. Hold that up. I'm going to show you what happened to our people. What do you know about history? Tell you your history.
As a so-called Jamaican.
What did they teach you?
You was born here?
Okay. What about your nation? I know in school, what did they teach you collectively happened to our nation? How did we get here?
As far as I know, this is Columbus.
Right.
As far as Jamaicanism, I'm awakened by your thought or your facts.
Okay. So you said Christopher Columbus, right? What did he do? He found land?
Yes, discovered.
Give me signs, 55 and 21.
Negotiate.
Okay. So, if you see those shoes on your feet? They're on your feet. They belong to you. If I stumble across them, I find them and say, oh snap, I like those shoes. They're mine now. Did I find it?
Bring it out.
Bring it out.
I found them? But they're on your feet.
Bring it out.
So what you're telling me is, if I walk down the street and I see you, I can take your shoes because I found them. I can say, hey, take your shoes off, man. I found those. Those belong to me. Knowing that you worked hard to get your shoes.
Right.
That's what happened to our people. We worked hard to fertilize the land.
Right.
To plant our crops.
Right.
To feed our children.
Right.
But a man decided, oh, this belongs to me.
Bring it up.
Plant this real quick. It belongs to me.
Bring it up.
Your house, it belongs to me.
Right.
Your land, it belongs to me.
Right.
Your children, your offspring, they belong to me.
Bring it up.
Read Psalms 55 and 21.
Psalms chapter 55, verse 21.
This body is out of game.
Bring it up.
They teach you lies in church.
Right.
They're not going to show you what this Bible is really about.
Right.
Christopher Columbus came here with smooth words. Hey, I got y'all.
Right.
Show me how y'all planted that right there.
Right.
And he seized us with smallpox.
Right.
Psalms chapter 55, verse 21.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
He came here crafty like a slithering snake. And deceived our people.
Right.
Smoother than butter. Read.
But war was in his heart.
His agenda was to destroy your ancestors.
Bring it up.
To kill your lineage.
Right.
To take your nationality.
Right.
To take your heritage.
Right.
To take your land.
Right.
By violence.
Right.
Read.
But war was in his heart.
We gonna kill him. That's the agenda. We're gonna kill all of them. They take their land, their clothes,
right.
Their children, their houses. Read.
His words were softer than oil.
Woo! He came in smooth, boy, and deceived the whole Western Hemisphere.
Right.
Read.
Yet, when they drawn sword, Yo, he came with a gang. He came with an army to destroy our people. That's our history. That's what happened to us.
Give me Deuteronomy 28:13. Okay. It's crazy what happened to our people. And they refuse to teach you this. They tell you the Jamaicans, they came around boats and, you know, now we here. Now we, you know, yellow and green, we cool. Nah, we better than that.
Right.
We came here on slave ship. Do you know that history? You don't know about that?
Yes. The first slave ship came from Europe. To Jamaica. Spain, excuse me. Do what you got, 21:15. 21:16.
Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt.
But Moses delivered the nation of Israel out of captivity. I tell you that, right? Out of slavery. Today, we are in slavery. Give me Egypt. I'm going to show you what Egypt means. Do you understand what happened to our people? I said a lot to you. Do you understand that this is the history that happened to our people? Why we was rich? These are the visuals so you can see. This happened to our people. We were scattered throughout the whole world.
Right.
That's why a Jamaican could say, well, Jamaican.
Right.
But I live in America. I'm Haitian, but you know, I live in Haiti. This is what happened to us. You see this right here? This is not sweet.
Yeah.
We didn't choose to do this.
Right.
We was forced to do this.
Yeah.
With swords at our necks. With swords pointed at our children.
Yeah.
Packed on a boat.
Right.
You got people bleeding. You got people dying. You got people taking a dump. You got sisters on their menstrual.
Yeah.
Stinks you there, man. This isn't sweet. Read that, man.
Deuteronomy chapter 5, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
I am the Lord thy God. Let's brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
That word Egypt, right?
From the house of bondage.
Egypt in the Bible means bondage. What's another word for bondage, brother? Bondage. Bondage is evil, right? Evil, another word for bondage is slavery. Captive. And holding. Bond. Right? Listen, this Bible is not a game. I guarantee you, your pastor will read this to you. This is in every Bible.
That's
our
right.
History is in every Bible. Because it belongs to us.
Right, right.
Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt.
Egypt, which means
slavery.
Again, with ships.
With what?
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
God says that the nation of Israel, if they don't keep that contract, that they will go into slavery with ships.
That's right.
He wasn't speaking to the Jamaicans, though.
Right.
He wasn't speaking to the so-called African Americans,
right.
The Negroes.
Right.
He was speaking to the nations of Israel. Hey, how you doing, brother?
I love you. Already know.
Hey, okay, okay, cool. 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 How you doing? How you doing?
Look, get me in here, man.
Wait.
Get me in
brother
here.
Anthony.
Man.
You hear me?
I'm doing good.
What happened
man.
To us, man?
I'm doing good, man. I didn't meet you last time. I met you. I
didn't
meet you.
No problem, no problem. We're teaching our brother right here that he is God's chosen people. Deuteronomy 28:16. Finish that. We went into slavery on slave ships. Is that not our history? Did that not happen to your ancestors? That happened to our forefathers. We can't deny that. That was forced on our people. But because we don't keep God's commandments. Really? Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Slavery again.
With ships.
With ships.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt see it no more again. Ever since your ancestors got to Jamaica, did they ever go back to where they belong?
Bring it out.
Because if we were forced on ships, that doesn't make it our land.
Right.
We don't belong there.
Right.
We don't belong here.
Bring it out.
Did we ever go back? Nah. We're still in captivity.
That's
we're
right.
Still hostages. after he done.
Galatians.
Deuteronomy 28:68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. By the way whereof I spoke unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
You will not see where you came from the
dead. And there,
when you get
off those slave ships, ye shall be sold.
You shall be what?
Ye shall be sold.
You shall be
sold. Ye shall be sold. Were sold to who? Unto your enemies.
Whoa.
Who sold us into slavery?
Put that on the screen, sir.
Who sold us into slavery? What nation of people sold us right when we got off these slave ships? Do you know? We got the images right here for you. So you can see what happened to our people. We were sold on auction blocks. Brother, listen to me. Jimmy, when we got off those slave ships, what happened to us? We were sold to who? To the white man. That's our history. That's our history. Right here, we were sold on auction blocks. Here, I got Anthony. $5, give me $5. $10, give me $10. They were selling you for way less than you're worth.
Right.
Sold to Mr. Thomas. Master Charles. In Virginia. In Jamaica.
Right.
Sold. We'll go bring some cotton.
Right.
We go. And then you shall be sold unto your enemies.
For what, man?
For by men. And by women. And slave women. That happened to us. That happened to the Israelites. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are God's chosen people.
Right.
These evils happened to us because we broke God's laws. So you should be asking, if these happen to us, the contract, what do we do? What do we break? If God put us on slave ships, what do we do to make him so mad? Give me Numbers 15:38. Deuteronomy 10:12. So let me ask you again. What's your nationality? What's your nationality? What nation of people do you come from? You American? Ah, so check me out. American, right? The first people that was here was who? The first nation that was on this side of the earth, North America. The so-called Native Americans.
That's right.
The tribe of God.
Right.
Also from the nation of Israel.
That's right.
Right? Christopher Columbus came here and what? Stole the land.
Right.
Not discovered. That's what they teach you. That's what they want you to think. That's what they indoctrinated you with. So that way, now we can celebrate Columbus Day. Now we can celebrate the destruction of our own brothers.
Right?
Right? So if they were the first peoples here, they were not calling themselves American. If another man, the so-called white man, stole the land and called himself American, does that make you an American? You do not descend from the white man. How could you be American? You said you're American, huh? God says that we are the Israelites. God says you are a Benjamite. From the tribe, you are a Benjamite from the nation of Israel.
Right.
Deuteronomy 10:12. I'm gonna show you what God requires of you. Cause it's not just to walk around and do what you want and hold out the sisters and smoke and party and club.
Right.
That's not what God put you on this earth for.
Right.
Read. Deuteronomy 10:12. And now, Israel, and now Anthony, what doeth the Lord thy God require of thee? But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways.
All his ways, not the ones that you just like.
Read.
And to love him.
To love
God.
Do you know how to love God? How do you love God?
Pray to Him.
Mm-hmm. Same thing. I'm gonna show you what love is according to the Bible.
Steady pace.
Okay. I'm gonna show you what love is. 1 John chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God, that we keep His commandments. Plain and simple. If you love God, do what I tell you to do.
Right.
Keep my commandments.
Right.
That's your duty.
Right.
Deuteronomy 10 and 12. And His commandments are not grievous.
Right.
It's not hard to do God's laws. It's not hard. Go back. Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, what doeth the Lord thy God require of thee? But to fear the Lord thy God.
Fear God.
To walk in all His ways. And to love Him. To keep His commandments. And to serve. To keep His commandments. The Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
With all thy heart.
Right.
And with all thy soul.
Right.
To keep the commandments of the Lord. Same thing. To fear Him. Keep His commandments.
Right.
To love Him, keep His commandments.
Right.
To serve Him, keep His commandments.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.